Hello students, let us discuss isomerism in the coordination compounds. First of all, what do you mean by isomerism? The two or more compounds having the same molecular formula but different arrangement of atoms are called isomers, and the phenomena is called as isomerism. Let us see the types of isomerism in the coordination compound. It is of two type, structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. What is structural isomerism? It arises due to the difference in the structures of coordination compound. It means the isomers having the same molecular formula but different structural arrangement of ligands around the central metal ion is called as structural isomerism. Structural isomerism is further classified into four types. Stereoisomerism, it arises due to the different spatial arrangement of ligands around the metal ion. So this year we have only structural isomerism we need to discuss, and here in this geometrical isomerism. Optical isomerism is not there for the syllabus. So let us discuss the four type of structural isomerism and geometrical isomerism in this video. First, let us discuss what is this structural isomerism and its type. As we have defined it already, structural isomerism is a phenomena in which the molecule have the same molecular formula but they have different structural arrangement of ligands around the central metal ion. So let us learn the details of the structural isomerism. First isomerism that we are going to discuss in the structural isomerism, that is coordination isomerism. It is observed in compounds having both cationic and anionic complex ions. As we have learned the type of complexes in which we have learned cationic anionic complex, that means in which both the cationic species and anionic species is there. For example, this example, what is the isomer, that is the coordination isomer for this molecule, that is this one. Now how you can write the isomer for this one? That is, it is observed in the coordination compound which have both cationic and anionic complex ion. So when you look at these two examples, it is very clear that here the distribution of ligand with the central metal ion in the coordination sphere is different. That is, here ammonia is with platinum, but when you look at in the second here, Cl is with platinum. And here Cl is with Cu, and but here Cu, ammonia is with Cu. So how you can easily write the coordination isomers once a molecule is given to you, once a coordination compound is given to you, how you can easily write its coordination isomer? Just exchange the ligand or just exchange the central metal ion. So just exchange. In the place of PT, you write Cu. In the place of Cu, you write PT. So you will be getting this isomer. So the coordination isomerism, it is a type of isomerism occur in the compound in which having both cationic and anionic entities. And the isomers differ in the distribution of ligand in the coordination entities of cationic and anionic part. So when you find it out, the molecular formula will be same, because here one PT, one Cu, here also one PT, one Cu, and here 4NH3 Cl4, here NH34 Cl4. So that means the molecular formula is same here, but what is the difference? That is the distribution of ligand is different here. So how you write this? Very easily, just exchange the central metal ion. So keep the ligand as it is, just exchange the central metal ion. then you can easily frame its isomer. Next type, that is ionization isomerism. It is found that in some of the cases it have a same molecular formula, but in the aqueous condition they ionize to different ions. That means when it get ionized, it gives a different ion. So that is based on the ionization concept. So that is actually how you can find it out an isomer, that is an ionization isomer. That is, its counter ion will be different. So when you look at this, here counter ion is sulfate ion, and here the counter ion is OH, hydroxide ion. So that means the counter ion is different here. But when you find it out in both the cases, the molecular formula is same, because here OH is inside the sphere, but here OH is outside the sphere. In this case, SO4 is inside and here SO4 is outside. So ionization isomerism, it can be easily make, that is the ions, that is the ion which ionization that gives different ions in the solution, that is called as ionization isomerism. That is, compounds having same molecular formula but gives different ion in the solution, that is called as ionization isomer. So that is actually depending upon the ionization. So let us take one more example. This compound is given to us. So how these will actually ionize us? So when you look at the molecular formula for these, it is same, because central metal ion CO here. There are ammonia that you can see here, and sulfate is there, and Br is there, sulfate, Br. So that is, in these are the isomers. Which isomers? Ionization isomers, because they have same molecular formula but they gives different ion in the solution. That means when it ionizes, it gives a Br negative, and when this ionizes, it gives a sulfate ion. So that means they gives a different ion in the solution. So how you can identify this one? That is, on ionization, we can say that it is giving Br negative, and this one will be forming the positive complex. So this one on ionizes gives sulfate ion. So when we are doing the salt analysis for this, it giving the positive test for a bromide ion, and it gives positive test for the sulfate ion. That is, the confirmatory test for sulfate ion given will be this complex, and this complex will give the confirmatory test for the bromide ion, because on ionization it gives bromide ion, but on ionization the second one gives a sulfate ion. So this is what called as ionization isomers. So these two are the ionization isomers. Next one, hydrate isomerism. Hydrate isomerism arises when the different number of water molecules are present inside and outside the coordination sphere. That is, hydrate relates to what? It relates to water. For example, here, this example, when you look at in this example, here in the coordination sphere, 6 H2O are there. That means H2O is a ligand here. So when you keep one H2O outside, so like here, one H2O when you keep outside, you have to bring one Cl inside. So then the complex will be perfect. So here you can see that the coordination number is 6. How? Because the number of ligand is 6. When you look at here, the coordination number is still 6. Why? 5 H2O and 1 Cl. So 6 coordination number is maintained here. So when you are taking one water molecule outside the complex sphere, but you have to keep the coordination number as it is. As here the coordination number is already 6. So when you keep one H2O outside, the coordination number become 5. So you should not do like this. So when you are bringing one H2O outside, one counterion you have to bring inside. So then will it make the isomers. So that is what called as hydride isomers. Next type of isomerism, that is geometrical isomerism. Let us take one case, that is if the coordination number is 4, if the coordination number is 4 and if it is occupying square planar complex, then it can form two type of isomers, that is if it have a general formula MX2L2, where X and L are the unidentate ligand and X and L are both different ligand. So in that place we can say that the two type of isomers which is possible, that is cis and trans. So let us make one example here. In this example you can see it is a which type of complex, that is MX2L2 type of complex. Why? Because here the PT is a central metal ion and it have two different ligand, as it is given X and L here in the general complex, and this is R in 2-2 in number. So what is the coordination number here? That is 2 ligand here, 2 ligand here, so total 4. So coordination number is 4. If it is occupying a square planar complex, then the two isomer which is possible, that is cis and trans. Now what is cis and what is trans? If the ligands, that is the two ligands, if it is arranged adjacent to each other, then it is called as cis form. In this example, you can see the two same ligand is on the adjacent side. Here two NH3 are on the adjacent side, that is on the same side. Then it is called as which form? Cis form. But when the same ligand are opposite, like here, the two Cl are opposite here to each other and two NH3 are opposite to each other. So in that case, that isomer is called as what? That is trans isomer. So it is very simple to identify cis and trans, or how you make cis and trans, just by keeping the two similar ligand on the same side, like here, that is on the adjacent side, and when you keep it on the opposite side, then it will be a transform. So this is occupying actually which form? That is occupying a square planar complex. Why? Because it is the ligands are occupying the corners of a square. So such type of complex having a square planar complex, and if it is of MX2L2 type, then the two possible isomer is cis and trans. That is, if the two similar ligands are on the adjacent side, then it is cis, and if it is on the opposite side, then it is called as trans. So that is what this type of isomers, that is cis and trans isomers. So it is a geometrical isomerism. Let us take the complex in which the coordination number is 4, but the ligands are of four ligands are different here, that is A, B, X, L, and all are unidentate, then it form three isomers. From this, two are cis and one is trans. So if the complex having coordination number 4 and all the ligands are different, like it is shown in the general formula, so from that and all are unidentate, in that case there will be two cis possibility and one trans. But if the complex having the coordination number 6, when the coordination number is 6, that is octahedral, they form octahedral complex, and if it is of MX2L4 type, then it form two type of isomers, that is cis and trans. Let us make one example for this. This is the example. So it is which type of complex here? That is MX2L4 type. Why it is MX2L4? Because M is a central metal ion, that is CO here, and here you can see two type of ligands are there, that is X and L as shown here. So two type of ligand, that is NH3 and Cl, are the two different type of ligand. From this, one of the ligand is 4 in number. So which one is 4 in number? Look at here, 4NH3 and Cl2, that means it is a which type? That is MX2L4 type of complex. So if the general formula MX2L4 represent the two different ligand, from that one of the ligand is 4 in number and the other one is 2 in number, and both the ligand are here unidentate. So in such case, the two possibility here, that is the cis and trans. Now look at here how it is cis. If the ligands are adjacent, then it is forming a cis, and if it is opposite, then it is trans. So when you look at here, NH3 are adjacent, and you can see there is no ligand which is oppositely same. One is same here, this is, but don't consider this one. The other all opposites are different here. But when you look at the second structure in this, here these are oppositely are the same ligand. Here also the ligand opposite to each other, and here also the ligand is opposite to each other. That means the same ligands are opposite on this and on this. So that is actually the trans. So don't look at this one are adjacent. So more priority here, it should be given opposite. So this is the trans form. So cis form, in this the ligands are adjacent to each other, and in this the ligands are opposite to each other. So that is a cis form and trans form isomerism. Let us do a textbook question, that is a textbook in-text question related to isomerism. The question is, indicate the type of isomerism exhibited by the following complexes and draw the structures of these isomers. So we need to indicate the type of isomerism possible in this, and you have to indicate, you have to make the structure for this. So first one, in this complex, it is of which type of, that is, it is of geometrical isomerism. It shows geometrical isomerism because here oxalate to ion is there, that is actually bidentate ligand. So bidentate ligand means it will be coordinated through two atoms, that is two donor atom is present. So the two possibility here, that is cis and trans. Now how it is cis and trans? Look at this one here, oxalate, because here the coordination number is 6. Why it is 6 here? 2 water, that is a unidentate, but it is 2, but it is a bidentate ligand, so you have to multiply with 2. So that is 2 plus 2 into 2, that is equal to water 6. So coordination number is 6, so it forming octahedral geometry. So this is an octahedral geometry. Now when you keep the two water on the axial planes, on the axial side, that is one is above the plane, other is below the plane, and the two oxalate is actually occupying the which position? The square position it is occupied by oxalate. So this is actually transform. Why it is transform? Because these are opposite, you can see. The similar ligands are opposite. The two water which is here, that is opposite here, and the two oxalate, it is also opposite. So that type of isomer is called as trans, because here it is opposite. The similar one ligand is opposite. Here also the similar one is opposite. So that is trans. But in the case of cis, you can see it is not opposite, it is adjacent. Next one. In this one, when you look at here, this is actually showing optical isomerism, that is they having the non-superimposable mirror images. Third one, in this complex, when you look at here, one of the ligand is ambidentate. So what will be the possibility of isomerism in this? That is linkage isomerism is possible. So how you make the isomer for this one? Just change the NO2 into ONO. So that is the complex is ready. This is the isomer for this complex. So how you easily you can make such type of isomers? Just change NO2 into ONO and you can see the rest of the everything is same as it is. So such type of linkage is called as is giving rise to the linkage isomers. Fourth part, in this complex there is no ambidentine ligand, so definitely linkage isomerism is not possible. But when you look at here, it is of which type of complex? That is a having a coordination number 4, because 1 NH3, 1 water and 2 Cl negative, that means coordination number is 4 here. So and definitely it will be forming a square planar complex. So what is the two possible isomer here? That is cis and trans. So geometrical isomerism is possible. So from this, two similar one is the ligand Cl here, that you keep it on the adjacent side. So that will be a cis one, and that you could keep it on the opposite side. The similar one, when you keep the ligand on the opposite side, then it is trans. So this can form cis and trans isomers. So that is an example of geometrical isomerism. So this is what we have discussed in this video. Have a nice day.